This channel is supported by my Patreon page. If you want to get a chance to be entered into the giveaway to win a signed copy of Daniel Love's book, Are You Dreaming? Then just donate $1 a month.
Thanks. On with the video.
Yo, what's up, fam squad? It's your boy Gears back at it again with another video. Today, I'm going to be talking about an event that I was at the other day and give you a link towards the event so you can see what I was doing. The other day, it was International Lucid Dreaming Day, April 12th, and on that same day, I was at an event and I was doing a talk on lucid dreaming. Now, as I've said, I've talked about lucid dreaming to people for ages and ages and ages now, over 10 years, but I've never talked at a group of people about lucid dreaming. Never even thought about doing that. And I was invited to talk at a conference about lucid dreaming, and I did. And it was the first time I've ever done a public speaking role, and the feedback I got was quite good, because people were very happy, or surprised at least, from the general feedback that I had, that I never have spoken in front of the people before doing that. The whole event was being live streamed, so if you managed to see like my Twitter post or something else like that about the live stream happening, then you probably saw the event itself. But I will link below the actual event and the live stream in total, and there's a timestamp that will appear here about the time that I appeared on stage. A couple of questions some people may have. No, I wasn't nervous. I don't really feel nervousness or anxiety or stress. So I was pretty chilled about leading up to the event. Normally, like when I feel nervous about something, because it is very rare, it's a very weird sensation that I feel. But generally when I'm doing, like say for example, I was singing back in the day when I was in bands and things, the only time I'd ever get nervous, not the lead up to singing, not actually singing, but it would be the time in which I'd take a deep breath to say my first line or to say hello to the audience, something like that. And then that would be the only time I'd ever get nervous. But I didn't even experience that this time, which is unusual because, you know, sometimes it's nice when you're somebody like me who's very neutral about feelings and emotions and things, to feel nervousness at least once or twice a year. Very annoying that I didn't, but you know, it helped. I had practiced the talk in front of a mirror lots and lots of times, and I had it down to a T. I had it timed to the exact time that I needed, but when I got up on stage, most of that information, it didn't fly out my head, but I just got onto a tangent about something else and forgot about the thing that I was gonna talk about, which is annoying. So in the future, flashcards indeed. As I said, the feedback was pretty good. I was talking to some people after, during the break, and they came up to me and there were some really interesting conversations about lucid dreaming. So from my understanding, people were very appreciative of the fact that it was a different talk, it was unique, and people seemed to really gel with the idea of what I was trying to communicate. So I thank the folks at KernowDAT, the team, especially Tony, for having me on the stage, showing everybody the wonderful world of lucid dreaming to a group of people who not normally would have heard about lucid dreaming. One of my favorite things about that night was during the talk, I was saying that to increase professional development, you are able to go to like the Sydney Opera House or Madison Square Garden, and you can get a group of people, a massive audience of thousands of people, and then you can deliver your talk or your speech and be able to practice in a real life setting. At the end, I said, are there any questions? And then somebody popped their hand up and said that, did you practice this talk in a dream? And I said, no, I could have, and I probably should have. But even though sometimes you think about doing something in a dream and you've got it written down on a bit of paper, maybe as a goal list or something, still, even though you've got it all planned out, when you eventually get into a lucid dream and you're in the situation, that plan can just get thrown out the window and you go, oh, I just fancy flying instead. And I just love that, the fact that I was preaching about doing this and I never did. Isn't it ironic? It was a great experience. I'd very much like to do talks again. Next time I'm gonna not deviate away from the point that I was trying to make, and maybe that'll make the experience a bit better for everyone. Thanks everyone for watching this video, a little bit about an explanation about what I've been doing over the past couple weeks. If you want to see the full talk, I'll leave a link in the description box below. Hopefully I'll be able to put a timestamp on it so that you can flick straight to me, and I'd be very appreciative of feedback. If you live in the Cornwall area, then subscribe to KernowDAT, which is the channel I'm linking to, because they have interesting talks quite regularly. So until then, Bye.
Thanks everyone, click the subscribe button, hit that bell to get notified each time I upload. There's my last video, click it, watch it, and there's my channel, click that too. Cheers.